most of the 20th century, people had to work hard to gain access to media outlets. In the 21st century, anyone with an internet connection can get a message out in seconds. This way, making public relations to appear in a broad field in this century. PR expanded worldwide as a management function, as a profession, as a process, and as a communication connection with a certain public.
Public relations involves the planned promotion of goods, services, and images of organizations intended to create goodwill for a person, place, or event. Public relations is all about reputation. It is the result of what you do, what you say, and what others say about you. It is used to gain trust and understanding between an organization and its various publics, whether that's employees, customers, investors, the local community, or all of those stakeholder groups. However, there is not one single generally accepted definition of public relations. Instead, there are many ways to define it.
Public relations, yeah, I've heard about it. It's the communications between the public with some famous people or a company or something like that.
Hi, I'm AD Davis from YMCA, and I'm just going to briefly tell you what PR means to me. PR, I actually didn't know what it meant to start with until someone just told me. But I understand it as it's everything to do with your brand in terms of showing people what you're doing. Getting out messages, getting out calls for action, stuff like that. It's everything from social media to how you have your newsletters and how you have your website. It's everything. I don't really know. I know I do it, but I don't know how well I do it. I hope that helps.
It's a process of communication between people and media.
PR is commonly associated with journalism, advertising, and mostly marketing.
Public relations. I think it's related to marketing, some kind of promotion that public companies use.
This is justified reasoning, as all four have similarities. Yet, PR differs greatly from each. The main goal of marketing is to sell goods and services, whereas PR is more towards creating a good image for an organization or an employer. PR deals more with specific demographic according to the organization, and marketing tends to be directed towards a specific audience that marketers are trying to reach and to win over.
The whole PR idea is about bringing the public near to your company and showing them what your company does and what you have to offer about them. If the PR isn't good enough, then the product has to be what it promotes the company itself. That's my idea of PR.
I'm Alberto Radomi. I work at the municipality of Giacova as head of the information center. I have a business background. I studied Masters of Management at the University of Sheffield in Thessaloniki. So my experience and my academic background has helped me equip my skills and knowledge to achieve the positions that I worked and I work now. But working in a public institution is a different story. So you have a great responsibility also to the citizens, because I am the figure of the municipality, so in many cases I have to represent the municipality, and people perceive the message how you interpret that. So most of the times you have to be on time and correct with the messages of the stories and the activities that happen in the municipality of Giacova. But what is PR and how do I understand PR? It's relatively a new concept, and as I've seen from the young people and the community here, they don't really understand the PR. They are used to journalism and newspapers, but PR is a bigger or greater concept because it relates different tools and different organisms, such as social media, newspapers, local media, television, and so on. And it's basically how you represent or how you communicate the stories or successes of a company or a public institution, activities, and so on. And considering this, we as a municipality have worked towards achieving a good or a better PR for the municipality. We have increased the number of followers in Twitter or in Facebook, so we are well represented in Facebook as well. For example, for each activity that happens in the municipality of Gjakova, we immediately post the information on Facebook and the pictures, so everything is transparent and in an efficient way, everything communicates well. Also, the communication with the citizens is very easy nowadays. For example, we refer to the comments or the messages that we receive from the citizens, and we get that feedback to improve something in the municipality. Whether it is a process or it is a request from the one person, so. The link between the city and the villages is closer. So this is PR, how you get to communicate with the people that you don't see or you don't have them close. So even in small cities, it used to be word of mouth, good PR. But nowadays, you use that and you use social media and you use all the tools that you have to create a better impact and to establish a better message to the citizens. And these are the things that we have done so far, and we understand that PR is very important even in companies, and everyone needs a PR expert. So we are working to promote and to have a greater PR for the municipality and to let the information to the people in the right time and in the right moment.
To succeed in PR, you have to have excellent written and verbal communication skills, to be hardworking and able to deal with a number of different tasks in one time, creative, determined, and persistent. You need to be adaptable with a good eye for a story and the ability to craft content. You need to be interested in business and understand that agencies need to make profit. Many people enter PR after experience in journalism, advertising, or marketing.
Well, first of all, thank you for deciding to interview me. My name is Lidona Osmanay, and I currently work for UNDP, the anti-corruption program. Before this, I was studying political science, international studies, and Spanish in the United States. I would say that PR, public relations, is a very broad field, so it depends on who you're talking to, on which answer you're gonna get. But to me, public relations is the managing of the spread of information from an individual to the public, or from an organization or a company or a governmental agency to the public. Like I said before, because public relations is such a broad field, you could be a public relations major, but you could be doing so many different things. For example, you could be helping, for example, the mayor writing their speeches, that is also PR. You could be writing press releases for the public. You could be running a media campaign, or you could just be working for an organization and trying to get the word out for a project. My advice for the youth of Kosovo especially is to definitely study public relations, because it is a major that I rarely see, and especially in this in the current economy, world economy, not only Kosovo, but especially for Kosovo being one of the poorest countries in Europe, I think finding a job is very hard to do. So doing something that not a lot of people do definitely gives you an advantage in the job market.
As a conclusion to everything said until now, public relations is the relationship between organizations and their publics. The PR professional must know how to effectively address those concerns using the most powerful tool of the PR trade, which is publicity. In addition, here are three young people inviting why PR is a good field to be studied.
I would call young people to be part of PR, mostly to study about it, because young people know what young people want, and that's where the whole project goes.
PR is the relation to everything and everyone. Everyone needs a good PR. Companies nowadays have a need for experts in PR, so maybe you can be that PR expert.
If you want an advantage, or if you want to stand out in the job market, then study public relations.
Thank you.